So Arkane Studios recently released their next game. This is Deathloop. Now, I was very excited for Deathloop for a number of reasons. One, Arkane Studios is fantastic, and they've released some of my favorite games of all time, including Dishonored, Prey, and Dishonored 2. Dishonored, in particular, I always view as a phenomenal stealth game, and one that really revolutionized my attitude towards stealth games. See, prior to my playing Dishonored, I was very familiar with games like Thief, or even Splinter Cell, which were a little slower and more methodical. Obviously, I liked faster, action-ier games, but stealth games I thought were worth it. Dishonored showed me that you didn't have to choose one or the other, you can have both and they can both be phenomenal blended together. All that to say, I had very, very high hopes for Deathloop. The marketing and the discussion around the game basically made it seem like Dishonored, but within a Majora's Mask type time loop. And while this is a little bit of a tangent, I think it is very important to note here so you know where I'm coming from. My single favorite game of all time is Majora's Mask. Majora's Mask is the one I'd point to if I could only play one game again for the rest of my life, it would be Majora's Mask. And if you aren't familiar with it, Majora's Mask takes place in a clockwork time loop that allows for 3 days passing. The time loop resets at the end of those 3 days, whether you reset it yourself or you die and are forced to reset it. But that's not the part that makes the game interesting. The part that makes the game interesting is since it is taking place in a clockwork time loop, things happen at different points of that time loop. At 2 p.m., a traveling Goron will show up for his reservation at the inn. At various other points in the clock during these 3 days, different events will pass, and you can mess with these events to bring about different futures. Now, Majora's Mask is dated. There's no question about that. They had plenty of reservations and restrictions while making the game that forced it not to be as open-ended as I personally would have liked, and probably as I viewed it as a child. It felt so realistic and living and breathing at the time, and replaying it, it's a little more, you know, video gamey. But for 20 years, I've always hoped that it'd be a spiritual successor to Majora's Mask that would utilize the same mechanics and allow a more modernized level of freedom. And Deathloop looked like that could be a contender. Which leads me to my biggest complaint about this video. Stop calling every time loop game Majora's Mask. Seriously. Majora's Mask was a unique style of clockwork, Groundhog's Day-ish, time looping bullshit, and it worked really well because they worked within the time frame, and I want another game to replicate that. At least something a little better than Outer Wilds, which is the closest thing I've seen so far. But Deathloop was not a clockwork game. In fact, Deathloop was barely a time looping game. Like, the time loop was more incidental, it was part of a puzzle, it was barely even a gameplay mechanic. What it really allowed was just slight variations to the levels based on what time of the day you go into those levels. So yeah, it is technically a time loop, but you weren't really working within a time loop. You were working within single, smaller, open world levels, and you were choosing the order with which to use them. It isn't really the same thing, and I'm getting frustrated that even after it's released and other people are debating whether this is a masterpiece or not, that they're still talking about this as if it's a clockwork game. It is not. This is not a time travel game. This is just a time travel puzzle built into a very linear chronological game. To be honest, the game is barely even open-ended. You are kind of led by the nose to each objective. There's no creativity in how you choose to solve your puzzles, and most of the outside puzzles that you could solve give you shitty rewards that aren't worth it. The game does not reward creativity, the game doesn't allow you to even think through your own solutions because the game tells you the solutions as you potentially discover them, and there's only one way to complete the game, and that's by going through their objectives and marking them off. It's a fun game. In fact, I think you can argue that it's a good game. I don't think it's an amazing game, so I'm a little surprised at some of the raving reviews, and this is coming from somebody who is very fond of the developers. I had a lot of fun with this. I poured hours and hours into it, and even though I'm not overly fond of PvP, I actually spent a fair amount of time just killing Juliana or being Juliana. It really is kind of a fun game, but it isn't a very complex game, and it certainly doesn't take a lot of brain power. And I guess a lot of this frustration comes down to the fact that I very much value time travel as a game mechanic in video games, and it is very rarely used. And even more rare is when it's used well. I can count on one hand the number of games that I think actually utilized time travel well and made it a very fun game mechanic. You have Chrono Trigger, obviously Majora's Mask, Life is Strange, Radiant Historia. Wow, how could I have forgotten Radiant Historia? But you really run out of more games that actually utilize time travel as a game mechanic. Also, Ocarina of Time doesn't count. F*** off with that shit. But what I'm trying to get at is that I love time travel as both a plot point, a setting, and as a game mechanic, and it isn't utilized very well, and it isn't utilized very often. So every once in a while when I hear rumors that there's a new Majora's Mask-like game, and then it isn't. It's very frustrating. It feels like when everybody refers to any slightly, mildly difficult game as the Dark Souls of whatever, stop misusing it. You're trying to get clicks, you're trying to get views, but you're really skewing this and making it very difficult for people who actually do want a game of that nature. And I'm still waiting for a spiritual successor to Majora's Mask. Like I said, the closest thing I've found is Outer Wilds, and that for me was really, really still lacking, as there's really no NPC interaction. It's mostly an interactive puzzle. All that being said, I do recommend the game. Deathloop is fun. I don't know if it's $60 worth of fun, but if it's ever on sale, you should absolutely grab it. It's not very challenging. It's a pretty mild shooter, but it is a lot of fun, and it has some very good writing, albeit no real f***ing plot. But that's another video. Play the game if you'd like, but go into it knowing what to expect. It is not Majora's Mask. It is not even really a time travel game. It's just a shooter. A fun shooter. A silly shooter, but a shooter. And with that, you all have a great day. If you know of any other time loop games or clockwork games specifically, please let me know down in the comments. I'm certainly down for trying out anything, but I really do feel like time travel is really underutilized in media in general, but video games especially. We have so many options and so much potential, and it's all squandered. Anyway, you all have a great day. Bye.